Hello. In the first presentation, I discussed meaning, features, and objectives of federalism, compared federal and unitary system, and routes to form federation. Today, I'll talk about what makes India a federal state and role of judiciary in a federation. The features of federalism, which we discussed in the previous presentation, apply to India also. So let's take up the various features and discuss in Indian context. As a federal state, India too has more than one level of government. We have three levels of government. The constitution originally provided for two tier or levels of government. However, in 1992, by the 73rd and 74th amendment, the third tier was added, that is, panchayats and municipalities. The second feature that makes India a federation is division of powers. The constitution distributes lawmaking powers between center and state governments through three lists, which are union list, state list, and concurrent list. Let us discuss the three lists one by one, starting with union list. Union list contains subjects of national importance. The subjects like defense, currency, banking are included. All those subjects which require uniform rules throughout the country are included in the union list, and only the central government has the power to make laws on the subjects mentioned in the union list. Originally, the constitution provided 97 subjects, but after amendments, now there are 100 items in the union list. Now let us discuss state list. The state list initially consisted of 66 items, but now it has 61 items in it. It includes subjects such as police, agriculture, irrigation, trade. The state governments make laws on the subjects included in it. However, the constitution empowers the central government to make laws on subjects of state list during national emergency, or if two or more states give their consent to do so to the parliament, that is central government. The third list is concurrent list, which initially contained 47 subjects but now has 52 subjects. Both the center and state have power to make laws on subjects mentioned in the concurrent list. Subjects of common interest like education, population control, forest are included in it. However, if a conflict arises on a law passed by central and state legislatures on the same subject, then the central law would prevail. That is, central law would override the state law. The next feature of Indian Federation is rigid constitution. The Indian constitution is flexible as well as rigid, which means that certain parts of the constitution can be amended by simple majority. However, the basic provisions cannot be amended unilaterally by one level of government but through special majority, which means that such an amendment needs to be approved by two-third majority present and voting in both the houses of parliament and ratified by 50% of the states. The highest lawmaking body in India is the parliament, which is bicameral. That is, it comprises of two houses, Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. Members of Rajya Sabha are indirectly elected by state legislative assemblies. And for this reason, the Rajya Sabha has powers to protect interests of states against union government. In India, like any other federation, center and state governments enjoy financial autonomy. The constitution specifies the sources of revenue for each level. Independent judiciary plays an important role in making power sharing more effective in Indian Federation. The disputes about the division of powers are settled by the High Courts and Supreme Court. In India, rule of law prevails. That is, law is supreme. No one is above the law. After discussing the features of Indian Federation, let us try to get a clear picture. Well, Indian Federation is a holding together federation. When our constitution was being framed, our constitution makers did not want to give more autonomy or power to states, because at that time, what they considered more important was consolidation of princely states. At the time of independence, there were approximately 565 princely states, and some of them did not want to be part of India. The constitution makers thought that center should be more powerful, and as Indian democracy would mature, changes in the constitution could be made to make India more federal. Another important aspect of Indian Federation is that the center is more powerful. As compared to state governments, center has more lawmaking powers. For example, it can make laws on subjects mentioned in the union list and concurrent list. The center also has the power to change state boundaries. Moreover, like Canadian Federation, the residuary powers rest with the center, which means that the center has the power to make laws on subjects not mentioned in either of the three lists. For example, cybercrime. As we are a holding together federation, all states do not enjoy equal powers. Various states like northeastern states, Maharashtra, Gujarat have been given special power for the development of certain regions and for providing adequate employment opportunities in those regions. On August 5, 2019, Article 370 was revoked, that is, cancelled. Prior to it, Article 370 provided the state of Jammu and Kashmir a special status. The state had its own constitution. The state legislature had residuary powers. Center could make laws for Jammu and Kashmir only with regard to foreign affairs, currency, defense, and communication. Non-permanent citizens could not buy land or house in Jammu and Kashmir. However, presently, as you know, it is a union territory. The union territories also have very little power. The central government has special powers to run them. Now let us discuss the role of judiciary in a federation. Judiciary plays an important role by ensuring implementation of constitutional provisions. It interprets division of powers and resolves conflicts related to it. Judiciary also ensures that the central government does not overstep its jurisdiction and interfere in the functioning of state governments. The Indian judiciary is regarded as the strength of Indian federalism. Kindly read page 16 and 17 of NCERT and try to frame answers to the questions given in Let Us Try.